Next generation weather forecast is Joe Schock here from stormchaserjs.com. I'm going to be doing something a little different today. This is actually my first weather event review that I'm doing to see how this goes. I got some data here and reanalysis. We're going to look back at yesterday's severe weather outbreak, August 23rd, 2020. We're going to review what led up to what was a very impressive severe weather situation for southern New England. And the forecast that we were looking at yesterday morning, which was underdone by a long shot, to say the least. So let's see what we have here looking at in today's review. So we're going to start off yesterday afternoon. As you can see, this is just as we come up towards 2 p.m. This was at 1:39, and I'm outside watering my plants. We knew there were going to be thunderstorms developing tomorrow, you know, in the southern New England area, you know, looking at Saturday's forecast for the modeling on Sunday. We knew that the next day, Sunday, the 23rd, was going to produce some thunderstorms along some sea breeze boundaries, some outflow boundaries from thunderstorms we had during the day Saturday. And we knew that area was going to be the Eastern Mass. But one of the things that was underestimated by pretty much all the models is how strong these would be. And a very, very surprising thing, too, which you'll see later on in this presentation, which really caught all of us forecasters off guard. I think we learned a valuable lesson from this situation. So anyway, you can see there's a downpour developing here in southern New Hampshire. I believe this is just coming into Rockingham County now, but you can see just north of Nashua, heavy rain with a lightning bolt. You can see on the right side, I'm taking a picture of this cumulus cloud that's developing. And then a little bit later on, the severe thunderstorm warning comes out, and there you can see on the top what it looks like here, a big cumulus cloud. So you can really see there, 1:39, and a few minutes later, you can, let me go back over here. So 1:39, and this one, I believe, was also 1:46. 1:42. You can see it on the bottom there. So 1:39, it looked like this. And 1:42, so 3 minutes later, the severe thunderstorm warning comes on out. And you can see just a remarkable difference in the cloud appearance in 3 minutes. So this thing really exploded very, very quickly. And that's because of the atmospheric dynamics that we had in place yesterday afternoon, which made the environment very, very favorable for thunderstorms to develop very, very explosively in the region. Now, looking at some of the model guidance, at least yesterday morning, here's the high-resolution ensemble forecast model on the left from the Storm Prediction Center. And here's what's actually going on as we get close to 3 o'clock in the afternoon. You can see a pretty good representation of the thunderstorm activity compared to what the model had. Almost identical. So a very, very good handle on this whole process developing from this HDWRF NSSL model that you see there. Then as we get into 4 o'clock in the afternoon, these are when the whole line that you see here in southern New Hampshire begins to congeal and develop here in Essex County. And you can see now we're starting to get additional severe thunderstorm warnings that start popping up just around 4 o'clock. And you can see the velocity, a tremendous, tremendous length. This was a high precipitation supercell. And you can see with all that lightning that is going on, you can see the very, very heavy rain and possibly some hail going on here, that this was really exploding quite quickly on additional outflow boundaries and sea breeze boundaries that were over Essex County at the time. And you could see definitely just incredible amount of lightning that this was. And there was just continuous thunder and lightning here where I live. And it was really, really impressive to see that come through. And again, there's that enhanced damaging wind showing up there in the bright greens just to the west of Topsfield, just to the east of 93L at 4 p.m. yesterday afternoon. As we get later on into 4 o'clock hour, again, that whole line is now from Cape Ann all the way out towards Worcester, with a second piece, Worcester County, staking southwest towards Springfield. And this really became a damaging wind threat from this point on forward as it moved off to the south and southeast. And now you can start to notice a big gust front beginning to develop from Worcester up toward just Metro West Boston. This light green line here where my mouse is, there's some damaging wind coming out of that. So we like to call that an outflow boundary. So as these thunderstorms move south, they're pushing wind out ahead of them, which is also a focal point for new thunderstorm development. Like you see here, south of Worcester, some additional thunderstorms are developing along that outflow boundary. So a very, very impressive situation, to say the least, at the time as we go into the 4 o'clock, almost 5 o'clock hour. And then as we move our way into the 5 o'clock hour, intense thunderstorm development continues. You can see that outflow boundary coming down through Brockton here, all the way across. Here's the velocity on the last scan down here. You can see those bright greens, that strong wind coming out of the storm. So a very, very impressive situation. And it continues to get more impressive because this was the Storm Prediction Center's outlook for yesterday. You can see just marginal risk. This should have been at least a slight risk day, if not an enhanced risk day. And there were no mesoscale discussions that came out from the Storm Prediction Center acknowledging the severe weather that was going on in southern New England at this time. Now, looking at the environment as we got into this situation, you can see here, this is surface-based Cape. You can see we have a lot of areas of 2 to 2,500 joules of Cape. So a very, very unstable atmosphere. Again, very supportive. They're very strong updrafts at this time. The low-level lapse rates, you can see are very, very steep. Anything over 6 is considered favorable for severe thunderstorm development. And as you can see, all of southern, much if not all of southern New England is at least 6.5 and as high as 8.5 in the Connecticut River Valley. So this supports very, very deep thunderstorm development. What a lapse rate is a change in temperature and height. So the steeper the higher these numbers are, the steeper the lapse rates are. So that's a pretty impressive signal. Mid-level lapse rates, the same thing. Quite unstable as we start getting up around 6. So that also favors very strong thunderstorm development. To see lapse rates over 6 like that, very, very favorable. Now, as we talk about the damaging wind threat here a little bit, something we like to look at is downdraft Cape. And you can see downdraft Cape at this time, anything over 800 joules definitely supports damaging winds. As you can see, we have 8 to 900. And earlier in the afternoon, we did have some 1,100 downdraft Cape here in the Rhode Island, Connecticut, Massachusetts region. So very, very unstable. So this downdraft Cape helps create damaging wind gusts coming out of these thunderstorms. That is why we had so many severe thunderstorm warnings and tremendous amount of wind damage reports, which are still coming in, by the way, today. So this is, again, a very, very favorable look for a widespread severe weather outbreak. Most unstable Cape in the parcel lift, you can see most unstable Cape is up around 1,500 to 2,000 joules, which favors, again, intense thunderstorm development. So there is a very, very positive signature there from the most unstable Cape. Looking at the 500 millibar pattern, you can see the thing that also, I think, set this off is you can see there's a little bit of a trough coming through the Great Lakes, which I think helped add some lift coming into southern New England. You can see at 500 millibars, we have a westerly flow at roughly 15 to 20 knots across the region. So that is why these storms are moving so slowly. We didn't really have a lot of wind to move these storms along. That's why we also had some flash flooding as well that occurred with these storms yesterday afternoon as they moved through. But again, you can see through the Great Lakes here how we have a little bit of a dip there in the height contour. That's a little bit of a shortwave trough moving through. 0 to 6 kilometers shear. Now, this is the part where I think we all learned a lesson. Usually when we look for severe thunderstorms, we like to see 0 to 6 kilometers shear, upwards of 30 to 35 knots and higher, which supports, you know, organized severe weather. But as you can see, this is valid at 4 p.m. yesterday afternoon. We have wind shear under 25 knots to 0 to 6 kilometer, and the models were not very excited about wind shear passing 20, 25 knots yesterday afternoon. So it was really surprising to see how this all got going, and that's what made me believe yesterday morning that it was going to be very, very hard to see severe thunderstorm development, widespread severe weather, without strong wind shear. But I think what happened is as these thunderstorms got going, they created their own environment, they had outflow boundaries, and then they took on a life of their own. And with that downdraft Cape, as high as it was, I think that downdraft Cape helped supplement for the lack of 0 to 6 kilometer shear during yesterday afternoon. But again, very, very little shear. Usually when you see little shear, you don't expect to see long-lived tracked severe thunderstorms like we did yesterday afternoon. So that was certainly a lesson that I think a lot of us learned from yesterday's case study. Now, effective bulk shear, you can see, not too great. We like to see this up around 35 knots. Again, we're barely 25 knots. So again, not a really favorable situation for severe weather. Again, we learned our lesson here that it looks like downdraft Cape and high instability might be able to make up for very low wind shear products in the 0 to 6 and 0 to 8 kilometers. So you can see what that looks like there. Now, an animation of the radar loop starting at 2 p.m. yesterday afternoon. You can see this downpour that I took a picture of, and then you can see the whole conglomeration of severe weather, and this is getting into the 4 p.m., and you'll just watch this evolution going through yesterday afternoon as this line continues to push up to the south. Nice bowing segments from the Cape Ann all the way up to Worcester County, a really solid line slicing through central and eastern Mass. And then you can see as it drops south into southeast Mass as we got into yesterday afternoon and weakening. And then an additional cluster going in Worcester County, which went through 8, 9, even close to 10 o'clock here and produced, again, some additional flash flooding where we saw upwards of 3 to 5 inches of rainfall during the day yesterday. And then additional thunderstorm activity here in western New Hampshire, which thankfully weakened coming off to the east. But again, a very, very active day yesterday here in southern New England. And we'll loop that through. We'll loop that through one more time so everyone can see the evolution of this. But here we are. Here's that first downpour. I'm taking a picture of that you saw at the very beginning of the video. A very, very impressive situation, to say the least. And again, there's that line getting going at the Mass-New Hampshire border, and now it's just taken off. And this is where we had a lot of our wind damage reports on the South Shore, which you'll see towards the end. Very, very impressive, I gotta say. Okay, we're gonna move on to our next slide here. Again, here's a shot, image I grabbed from the GO 16. This was at 4:21 yesterday. You can see again that line segment, these overshooting tops here. So this is the satellite and radar imagery combined. Again, here are the severe thunderstorm warnings with this line that was coming through. Multiple counties under severe thunderstorm warnings by the local forecast office here in Norton, and then special marine statements as well. Here's an animation of that process going on here. You can also see the outflow boundary picking up on the satellite imagery right through here with that little bit of a cloud feature. And this was yesterday starting at 3 o'clock going through roughly 4:45. Very, very impressive signature there with, again, damaging winds coming out of that line. Now, looking at some of the wind reports, Logan got a wind gust of 43. Here at 16:58, again, sustained at 30, gust of 43. Norwood got a gust of 59. Worcester got a gust of 62. Fitchburg got a wind gust of 47. And here is actually one of the severe thunderstorm warnings which came out. And this is very impressive. I mean, I have never seen a severe thunderstorm warning like this come out. And you can just see what it says here. Severe thunderstorm warning remains until 6:30. They go over the things and towards the end, this is an extremely dangerous situation in capital letters. That was pretty impressive to see this kind of wording in a severe thunderstorm warning. Again, I have never seen this kind of wording in a severe thunderstorm warning. So again, very, very impressive. And also they note here that NORAD reported a wind gust of 59 miles an hour at 5:47. So we've had history of wind damage with this thing coming through. That's why the forecasters who issued the severe thunderstorm warning, we're very confident in it because we've already seen history of that wind begin happening. So looking at the wind damage reports, again, you can see a high cluster of damaging wind reports here in southern New England. A close-up view, we had 52 damaging wind reports, and we had 3 hail reports. And again, there's still some wind damage reports coming in. So this probably will go up a little bit more over the next few hours or so. But again, 52 damaging wind reports. You can see a lot of that here focused within that line segment here and central and eastern Massachusetts as a whole. So a very, very impressive severe weather situation that we saw yesterday afternoon. And there may be some more severe weather today and tomorrow. So if needed, additional event reviews will happen as we go down the road. But that's it for now, and thank you for watching.